Welcome to Community Matters, brought to you by Washington County Department of Health and Human Services. I'm your host, Andy Cartmill. We're here each month with a variety of topics and guests with the goal of keeping you safe, healthy, and well-informed. Today, we are at the Hawthorn Walk-in Center for Mental Health and Addictions Care. Joining us is Rich Roll, Program Coordinator for the Washington County Crisis Team. And Rich, thanks for having us.
Our pleasure, Andy. We're excited to show the community what the Hawthorn Walk-in Center is all about.
Well, let's start from the basics. Who and what is the center for?
Well, the Hawthorn Walk-in Center was opened in May of 2017, and this is Washington County's first mental health urgent care center. This is a safe place where people of any age can receive assistance with mental health and addictions concerns that does not require hospital-based help. And we're here not only for people who want assistance, but for those friends and family members who have concerns about a loved one and don't know where to turn to consult about resources and supports. And our services, which are free and confidential, include assessment, crisis counseling and stabilization, education, and connection to longer-term treatment providers and other social services.
And are you open every day?
Every day of the year. From 9 a.m. to 8:30 p.m., we take walk-ins and appointments, though appointments are never necessary. And we are located conveniently by the Hawthorn Farm backstop.
So can you walk us through what a typical visit to the center might look like?
Well, one of our friendly and understanding receptionists will meet you at the front desk. They'll have some written information about our services for you, including your rights, such as confidentiality. And there'll be a little bit of paperwork to complete, and that helps our staff to understand your concerns and be able to develop a plan that works for you. And we also have a separate waiting area for children and their families, if necessary.
This is a beautiful lobby area, very comfortable.
Oh, thank you. Well, we've built in many features, both into the lobby and the center itself, to help our visitors feel welcome and safe, including this water feature, for instance. And the water sound helps create a soothing environment in the lobby, but it also supports confidentiality conversations here.
Okay, so what happens next?
So our next available counselor will be out as soon as possible to meet you and take you back to a private counseling room where we can talk more about what brought you to the center and what we can do together to assist you. And our experienced staff will provide brief counseling and education on mental health and addiction and help you get connected to resources and services that really will give you the support to move forward. And if, depending on the need, we have crisis prescribers who are available for temporary medication bridges.
And I understand you also have peer support specialists. Tell us a little bit about
that.
Yes.
Peer support specialists are men and women who are in recovery from their own mental health or addiction concerns. And they are professionally trained to provide caring and direct support for the people who come to our center for help.
I think we even have a clip. Let's take a look.
So I'm one of the peer support specialists here at the Hawthorn Center, and we're available to walk alongside participants during their crisis. We're individuals who are in recovery from our own mental health and addiction history, and we're here to offer empathy and hope. There are 6 certified peer support specialists on staff here at Hawthorn, both male and female, with a wide variety of experiences. We're trained in the intentional peer support model, which talks about walking alongside our participant rather than trying to problem solve for them. So we're here in the peer lounge, and this is a space that's designed to be a safe space where individuals can drop in and meet with a peer support specialist or make an appointment to see one of us.
What an amazing service, honestly. How much does this cost?
That's the great news. There is no charge to any individual seeking help. We do bill certain insurance, and we'll take information about that accordingly. But again, there is never a charge for a person coming here for assistance.
So anyone has access to the Hawthorn Walk-in Center?
Yes, we welcome people of all ages, origins, orientations, and abilities, regardless of income and insurance. Truly, all are welcome. We don't want there to be any obstacles to getting care at the Hawthorn Walk-in Center.
Let's talk for a minute about who is providing the service. Now, you don't work for Washington County. You work for LifeWorks Northwest. Is that right?
That's correct, yes. Washington County contracts with LifeWorks Northwest to operate the center. And LifeWorks staffs the Hawthorn Walk-in Center with master's level counselors, bachelor's level case managers, psychiatrists, nurse practitioners, as well as the peer support specialists that we just talked about.
And are you able to help people that don't speak English?
Absolutely. We have several Spanish-speaking staff here at the center, and we can also arrange for an interpreter if another language is needed. And I want to mention that if someone has a preference for a male or female counselor, we'll do our best to accommodate that. We want to do everything we can to help people feel comfortable who come here for help.
So what if someone needs help, but they can't get to the Hawthorn Walk-in Center?
In those cases, anyone can call through the Washington County Crisis Line 24 hours a day and request mobile assistance. In addition to seeing people at the walk-in, we also have the capacity to send crisis counselors into the community to help those who can't make it in.
So, Rich, would you consider the Hawthorn Walk-in Center the hub of mental health services in Washington County?
It really is. I mean, we're a short-term service, so we refer to a wide range of mental health and addictions providers throughout the county who offer ongoing services and supports. But we really do have a lot going on right here. In fact, we've made space available for community partners to bring their resources directly to our visitors. And a few of those community partners who are participating now include Community Action, the National Alliance on Mental Illness, or NAMI, and Dual Diagnosis Anonymous. And as you're aware, Washington County Behavioral Health is right next door, and the Oregon Department of Human Services is in the same office complex, as is Washington County Disability Aging and Veteran Services. So this really does make it easy for us to get people directly to the services they need.
Well, I would really agree it does. Now, one last but very important question. How does one access the services offered by the Hawthorn Walk-in Center?
Any day of the year, people can walk in from 9 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. And they can also call the Washington County Crisis Line anytime, 24/7, for help. And if someone would prefer to have an appointment to be seen at the Hawthorn Center, they can do so through the crisis line. But again, I want to say there's never a need for an appointment. We encourage and welcome walk-ins to our center anytime, 9 a.m. to 8:30 p.m.
Well, Rich, thank you so much for having us over, be willing to talk to us, and honestly, what a tremendous service and a needed service here in Washington County. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching. If you or someone you care about needs help with mental health or addictions issues, the Hawthorn Walk-in Center is here for you. Until next time, this is Andy Cartmill for Community Matters.